Moving pictures, silent films. Life out of windows, the little earth passing by as I am carried on wheels, over pavement or over tracks. Then the land and sea appear underneath me as I soar through the clouds. So many faces. They do their little dance, tears fall. They seem especially fragile and small as they move away from their imagined homes, traveling. Though I know they are always home. In train stations, bus terminals, airports, watching them all do the very same things. Everywhere. Little children playing, shushed, pulled to stay near their parents, then sleepily held on laps or spread across seats as a mother's eyes stay awake, watchfully. Feeding them, making sure they stay together when there's more than one. Panicked moments when one seems missing. But I saw her ducking under the seats and point her out. The mother is almost crying with relief and thanks me. The little girl gives me a frown for ruining the game. They eat food, go behind doors to get rid of their body's waste. Some grab the quick, sugary and salty snacks. Others, like the dancer, with no more dance company, sit at stainless steel wine bars, on metal stools, raised a few feet, so she can watch the dance that she is always dancing, the dance of life at play. Some sit alone and look lonely. Some sit alone and read. Many reach for their little lit-up phones or tablets. Glowing light reflected on their pale or earthy faces. Some hold others, some chat with energy early in their trip. Others seem weary. Some hold on to each other. Some seem to want to let go. And others try to get closer than it is possible to get. Some kiss and some flirt, some argue, some cry, and a few walk away angrily, usually chased after or coming right back. Perhaps others vanish into that unknown aloneness where I live, the vast emptiness that holds all of them, everyone I see. In the spaceless chasm of my heart. It is good I'm going to be away. I almost wrote, going to be put away. What a friend once called shape-shifting. Trying to act normally out in the apparent world of humans is harder, it seems, though there is no one here to try. A few people ask me if I'm all right, and I notice I have tears on my face. I want to say, yes, I'm fine. This beauty, this terrible love, is killing me, you know. But instead I tell them, yes, that's so kind of you. I'm fine, thank you. That seems like it will sound better. And it makes me cry that anyone notices and asks. After a man walks away following a few words, some woman says, "He was hitting on you." I shrug. I know no one is behind their words or actions, or the words and actions that come up trying to explain words and actions. and the words make less and less sense. I seem to prefer them in languages I did not have meanings attached to. At least then, I had a reason not to understand. But there never has been anything understandable. Just a story of understanding. And when the story is gone, there is just this. What has always been and never has been at all. Out of the windows of my imagination, I watch you live your lives. My heart breaks open with every moment. You beautiful dancers on the winds of dreams. I feel every emotion, recognize every thought. See the galaxies spin in your beautiful eyes, laughing or crying, living or dying. Always at home with you in the house of love, my beloveds.